Sustainable transport systems, along with quality and resilient infrastructure, are essential to implement the 2030 Agenda for Sustainable Development. The Asia-Pacific region is at the heart of the world's transport flows, accounting for more than 40% of global surface freight and two-thirds of seaborne freight, making international trade and commerce thrive and ensuring that goods and people get to where they need to go. While the region has made great strides in improving transport connectivity over the last decades, there is still more to be done to progress towards an efficient and resilient transport and logistics network and mobility to support economic growth. The United Nations Economic and Social Commission for Asia and the Pacific assists its member states in achieving this goal. Regional land transport connectivity and logistics. The size of the region's land transport infrastructure has grown to an impressive scale. The Asian Highway Network now comprises 145,000 kilometers of road across 32 countries, while the Trans-Asian Railway Network features 125,000 kilometers of railroad in 28 countries. Around 270 dry ports have been set up or are being planned in order to meet supply chain requirements by grouping access to highways and railways. Together with customs processing, warehousing, manufacturing, and clustering of economic activities. But the region still faces many challenges in transport. Infrastructure issues persist, including differing national standards in road quality and design, missing links between railroads and differences between gauges, and a lack of a consistent dry port design between countries. Non-physical barriers continue to hinder the free flow of goods within the region as well. This includes institutional and regulatory hurdles that can frustrate trade and transport. To create an efficient and integrated, multimodal regional transport system, member states need to prioritize their infrastructure development in line with regional parameters, so all the region's transport pieces fit neatly together. New technologies and digitalization offer great potential to improve transport efficiency by adopting facilitation tools and digital transformation, ensuring greater interoperability, and making the exchange of information easier. Maritime and interregional transport connectivity. The Asia-Pacific region is home to 9 out of 10 of the world's busiest container ports. Maritime trade is of core importance to the region's economic growth and is a lifeline to the small island developing states in the Pacific. The region also connects to the global economy by a network of international land transport corridors, with inter-regional trade gaining tremendous momentum, especially between Asia and Europe. But preserving and enhancing the region's positioning in global supply chains requires unwavering progress in connectivity and requires addressing a wide range of institutional, financial, technological, environmental, and legal concerns. Maritime and interregional connectivity for Asia and the Pacific needs to be addressed as a cross-cutting issue, with due attention to countries with special connectivity needs. So, what's next? To build the most effective transport links of the future, the countries of Asia and the Pacific must continue to work together and build on the dynamic regional network of land and maritime transport connections. This includes extending and upgrading the Asian highways, trans-Asian railways, dry ports, and shipping networks to support seamless transport operations, enhancing the resilience of transport systems, employing new technologies and digitalization, and continuing regional dialogue on transport connectivity. Whether by road, rail, or sea, let us ensure Asia and the Pacific enjoys an efficient and resilient transport and logistics system, fully equipped to meet the challenges of sustainability.